And now live from the Chao Stadium, it's week 7 of the Women's Division on Chao Racing 2022. Everyone is on the clock and ready to go. Let's have a Chao race! We are lifting high spirits for this November Sunday afternoon as Amber Norton, our defending Women's Division champion Molly Brown and Jessica Claymore are ready to have a party like no other. And this one's going to be a close one down to the wire, and by a photo finish, Molly Brown is the winner! That was one for the ages. Well done, Molly. Once again, here's the host of Chao Racing himself, Brandon Jennings. And the crowd goes wild for our reigning women's champ, Molly Brown. Thanks again, Paul. Molly Brown beats out Emma Norton and Jessica Claymore, and she gets another win crosser towards fulfilling her repeat title. Well done by Molly. Let's hope she keeps them next week. Back for race number 2 in a moment. Do not go away. What a close finish to start our week. And now for race number 2, Paul. It's Harper Grubber, Alina Booker, and Norma Kay. That's what we have for race number 2. Harper Grubber and Alina Booker have 2 wins out of the first 7 races. Norma Kay has just 1 win. So these 3 divas are trying to get back on track so that way they can make the cut for next season's 2023 Women's Division roster. Let's see who's still going to get that chance to stay alive. Please start the race! Alright, so Harper, Alina, and Norma are fighting to get enough wins on the board so that way that they can come back for 2023 next fall. And right now it is Alina Booker, who's leading over Norma Kay at the current moment. And it looks like Harper Grubber is heading for the water. And it looks like Norma Kay is going to wrestle. She'll be left behind from Alina Booker. And as number 7 takes the first speed rest, Harper Grubber paid off her shortcut strategy, and she's going to get a jump dot. Harper Grubber now has 3 wins up on the board with that incredible victory. What a deal! As Alina Booker will take speed rest number 2, I think she's going to wind up in 2nd place. Norma Kay will have to settle for 3rd place, but they're all winners no matter where they finish in each and every race. And Norma Kay will close out the speed rest. So a job well done by Harper Grubber for this week. Yep, it's nice for Harper to win today. Coming up, we got more exciting action for you. But first, have a look at this. Okay, let's hear about race number 3, Paul. For race number 3, we have Olivia Fortin, Rosa Elisa Tango, and that Dreamcast idol, Carly Hartman. So we have both our 3rd place and 4th place finalists from last season. Hopefully one of the 2 finalists from last season will be able to get wins, so that way they can have a chance of returning to the playoffs this year for 2023 and get another chance at becoming Women's Division Champion this season. We're about to find out right now. Let's mark this place! So will Olivia or Rosalie get another win closer towards returning to the playoffs? Or will our Dreamcast idol get another win on the board for once? There's only one way to find out. By now, Olivia Fortin and Colin Hartman are battling for the lead up in the front. And the first obstacle on the Sapphire course is the Stone Wall. That's the power version of the course. As number 8 will start the speed rest, and look at that. He's going to move up a couple places because 2 of the Silver Channel are going to rest, and another Silver Channel is pausing for it. So number 8 will move up to 5th place over the 8th Channel. And who will have the right to gain speed rest number 2? It is our 4th place finalist, Rosalie Sotango. And she is going to rest. She had the lead passing Libby and Kali. Now she's better to drop down back to 3rd place. And the next BUS belongs to number 1, who desperately needs to catch up every now and then. Olivia and Kali battling for the lead once again over Rosalie Sotango. Rosalie Sotango went a little too far off course. And number 6 will get the next command BUS. Olivia Fortin defending the lead over Kali Hartman for the 2nd time in this race. This time, Kali Hartman's not going to find any open hole. Olivia Fortin holds on for an easy victory. That's the last BUS win made by number 8. So it's 1 win closer towards coming back to the playoffs for 2023 for Olivia Fortin. Yep, let's hope she'll keep it up. Back in a bit. Do not go away. Well, that was an exciting down-to-the-wire contest from the last race. That's fine. It was a great win for Olivia Fortune. Okay, Paul, let's continue with race number 4. And for this next race, we're heading over to the booby course to test the swimming ability alone, as Pauline Carter takes on Sarah Granberry and Yasmin Arson. So, the players are lined up and ready to go. Everyone is on the clock, and let's have a chow race. Alright, and Yasmin Arson is going to rest. That means she'll be left behind in the competition for a while. Pauline Carter maintained a little breathing room ahead of us couple super chow up in the front. I'm surprised it's not the going chow. Pauline had 1900 points in all four of the main abilities. But how come there's only Silver Chow? Well, it doesn't matter for Pauline anyway. Pauline Carter gets the win. That's the one speedrest win made by number 7. Pauline Carter is now at 4-4. She evens her win-loss records at the 500 mark. That's right. Well done by Pauline, and there's more excitement coming up. Welcome back, folks. We still have 4 more exciting races to present you for Week 7 on the Women's Division this week. So, Paul, let's continue the action with race number 5. Alright, for race number 5, we go back to the pro course as True Johnson, Joanne Folksley, and Zoe Bayon prepare to push the balls with all their might. There they are, we place the balls on the field, and it's best of luck to our 3 divas out there. Please start the race! Alright, so all they have to do is push the balls to your side of the rainbow path, and the first diva to make it across the finish line in any standing will win this one. Joanne and True are pushing the balls up in the front, and it looks like Joanne Folksley is going to get to the finish line first. Joanne Folksley has the number win closer towards her redemption. Joanne's now up to 5 wins for the season. Yep, she desperately wanted another chance at a title, and we'll return for the next exciting summon after we hear from this word. And now, Paul, how about we simple it up race number 6? You got it. Race number 6 features Cheryl Days, Tony Griffin, and Polly Linklater. So in this next race, it's going to be held on the Amethyst course. These 3 divas really need to get their A game if they want to at least make the Monster Cut for next year. Let's see how this race unfolds. Best of luck to these 3 divas, and let's mark this place! And Cheryl Days is going to rest. That will give Tony and Pauline the opening edge. And it looks like, yep, Tony is turning to the crown. Which means Pauline Linklater will have a little bit of breathing room up in the front. Pauline Linklater trying to maintain the lead. And it looks like Tony Griffin is going to rest. As Cheryl Days trying to make a comeback here, takes the first speed bus on this base. Looks like number 8 is heading for the water here, folks. And so is number 7, who desperately needs help. As the superstar to get speed bus number 2, it's number 6, who is trying to catch up with Tony Griffin for 4th place. And right now, Pauline Linklater still has a commanding lead up in the competition. Looks like she's going to win this one easily. As number 1, who was turning to the crown, takes the next command. Yes, and poor Cheryl Days is getting left behind straight last place. Oh well, that's always another time. As she takes her second speed buzz, you can tell he went up for Pauline Linklater. That was an easy race. She improves to 500 with 4-4. How about that, Brennan? Yep, if Pauline keeps it up, she might come back next season. We'll find out soon enough. Back in a bit, do not go away. Alright, let's continue to heat up the electrifying action here in the Chao Racing Universe. Time for race number 7 of week 7, Paul. You said it. Race number 7 features Carol Donner, Marissa Heenan, and Mona Hartman as they get ready to go to work on the Sapphire course. The players are lined up and ready to go. Everyone is on the clock, and please start the race! Alright. Who is going to get a W this time? Well, number 8 is going to rest, so he'll be left behind in the competition. Carol Donna leaning over Rona Hartman as they make their way towards the checkered path. That's when they start on a sapphire course. And the first main obstacle is the stone wall. And we'll see how well they will climb up the wall once they touch it. As the first superstar to get speed bus is number 6. And he'll move up a couple places, maybe around 1 or 2 places at a time. Might about 5th place. And number 2 is getting straight in last place behind the sewer shower as they climb out the stone wall. As Rona Hartman, with a good chunk amount, takes speedbus number 2. She got a good chunk amount of speedbus that time. Trying to take away the lead from Carol Donna. All 3 divas are pretty close heading into the home stretch. As number 6 will get his second speedbus of the race. And he going leads over the 4-5 sewer shower to come on. And Rona Hartman is going to make her way towards the finish line right over there. As number 7 takes speedbus, getting a good chunk to stay alive. Rona Hartman is our winner. Rona wins an easy one over the competitors. That's right. Rona is now up to 5 wins, and we'll be right back to present the last race of the week in a moment. And now it's down to the last week divas for this week's Women's Mansion action. Tell us why. That's right, all we have left are Helen Benjamin, Ingrid Barlow, and Dana LaHue. So this is the big race for our Women's Mission schedule. We always say the best race for last. You know why? We are going to the Emerald Course. This is the big course of the Chowey Stadium. Let's see what happens here, and let's have a Chowey! And Ingrid Barlow is going to rest. So let's watch Helen and Dana. These two divas will have control of the opening edge. And Helen pauses for one just before she touches the palm trees, which are going to bring down that coconut chi food. And now they're going to eat the food. And there goes Daniel Hugh. He is going to be battling with number 2 and number 6 for the up and fun. And Helen Benjamin, who is heading for the water, will start on the speedbus for this race. I think she'll move up to the lead up in the front. Point number 7 is getting left behind the competition. He's better take the water as well, trying to maintain momentum. And who has the right to gain speedbus number 2? It is Ingrid Barlow trying to make a comeback after forcing to go to rest after starting gates. Right now, it is Helen Benjamin, who has a commanding lead over number 8 of the sewer shell up in the very front of the pack. But right now, all eyes are on Ingrid Barlow as she takes back-to-back speedbus, now moving up a couple more places. And now number 6 and number 7 are fighting for dear life. Number 2 passes for 1, so he'll join these two sewer shell. And Dana LaHue is going to, so she'll drop down to last place as the next PS win made by number 1. And now he leads over the 5 sewer shell with 2nd place. Meanwhile, Helen Benjamin up in the very front continues to dominate over the other 2 divas. Looks like she is going to win this one easily. She's climbing up the stone wall now. And Dana LaHue, trying to catch up with the crowd, takes the next command speedbus, but I don't think she'll make it all the way to first place. It will be a miracle for Ingrid Barlow to win this one as well. Looks like Helen Benjamin is going to hold on for the victory. And here comes number 7, trying to make a valley out being left behind with next speedbus. Yep, Helen Benjamin is safely in the lead ahead of number 1. Helen Benjamin is going to win this one easily, no doubt about it. Next PS belongs to number 1, and he dominates over the 5 switch out. That makes his 2nd speedbus of the race. Little too far that time, but oh well, she'll still have command of the lead over the 5 switch out. Helen Benjamin has this race all wrapped up, ladies and gentlemen. As number 7 takes the next command PS, trying to stay alive. Helen Benjamin wins this one in our filming week 7 finale. Helen Benjamin is now up to 3 wins for the season. Number 1 takes an easy 2nd place. And we have time for one last speed buzz for this week's Women's Mission show. And it will be made by number 6. He has no hope for surviving whatsoever, even with that speed buzz. So, how about that Helen Benjamin? Yep, she won this week, but how will she keep up with the pace? We'll find out. Closing messages after these messages. So, as you know, the annual Tournament of Champions is coming up in just 4 weeks. And we'll travel to Nairobi, Sydney, in Kenya. That's where they will host the 2022 Child Racing Tournament of Champions. Hopefully, Casey will have a good child for the USA as he prepares to make his memory card roster for the 2022 tournament. We'll have more inside details later. In the meantime, thanks for joining us for Chao 2022 for the week of November 20th, 2022. We'll be back next week for more heating, exciting action. Until then, it's Bad Shank signing off. Keep on smiling, have a safe and happy Thanksgiving week, and so long, everybody! Chao 2022 has been sponsored by Clorox and Chick-fil-A. This is Paul Sagamore signing off. Join us again for more exciting action here on Chao 2022. Happy Thanksgiving and see you next week.